Well, good morning, everybody. Today is Monday after the Super Bowl. What an exciting game that was. Holy cow. Tell you what, I took the day off today because I had a day to burn, and I figured, why not? If I take the day after Super Bowl, then I definitely can stay up and watch the Super Bowl. And I was glad I did because, man, it was an exciting game. My wife is a Patriots fan, and the whole game she kept saying, oh, no, this is looking so bad for them. Atlanta's just, I don't even know why Brady thinks he can compete out here. And I kept telling her, I said, just hang on. He's a Hall of Famer. Anything can happen. And boy, was I right. Whew, that was an exciting finish. I can't believe they pulled it off. Anyway, I'm out here in the garage today. It's kind of a chilly day here in South Carolina. It's 34 out there. You can't really see much. The camera's got to adjust. It's kind of wet outside and 34. Brr. But, you know, I'm in the garage. Why not? I want to talk about something. I've been wanting a decent radio out here in the garage, preferably something that I could hook up Bluetooth with my phone, or you know, some type of device to have music going or podcast going while I'm out here in the garage. Let me spin you guys around. So in the house, I had these speakers sitting in there that have actually not been hooked up since we moved here. I had a receiver, tuner, radio type deal, head unit in the house, and I just never hooked them up. Never had the need to. And I thought one day, I said, you know, I had a guy I was working with who said he was looking for one because he had a tuner, a phonograph player that he wanted to hook up to it to play records. And I said, well, I got one I ain't used in literally 15 years that you can have. I said, matter of fact, I'll go home and make sure it still works. Well, I plugged it up to the speakers. I built me another shelf because I have a shelf building addiction. I built me another shelf and I put speakers up there, and I drilled holes and ran wire down and I hooked it up, and I was like, oh, this sounds great. And I guess while I was tinkering around with it, I bumped it and it fell and hit the ground, and then it didn't work no more. So I had to tell them, I'm sorry, it doesn't work. Kind of disheartening. I opened it up and the circuit breaker motherboard thingy had cracked, and I was like, well, that's too bad. So anywho, I went online and I found this thing. Now this is supposed to put out, it says online that it puts out 200 watts, and it looks like it's got a place. It does Bluetooth, it has USB, an SD card slot, has an FM digital player hooked in. So, yeah, so I'm gonna try it out. It only cost me like $26 with shipping on eBay. So let me give it a shot. All right, so I got it plugged up. It's got a thing in the back where you can hook it up for AC or DC power. It's set up so that you can hook it up to your boat or your RV or whatever. I'm not real a fan of the blinky light thing, but whatever. I can turn it on, but you're going to hear music, and then you guys are going to be like, you know, wait, can you play that on YouTube? So let's just see. That way nobody can say, hey, so-and-so's that's so-and-so's content. So anyway, I'm learning how the little radio part works, and I got to learn how to sync it up with my phone so that I can listen to Bluetooth stuff or my music on my phone. But anywho, it's got a simple power button. Turn power off, and that's it. I like the fact that the back of this has got a spot to just plug in your speakers. It's also got the LNR in case you want to put in another input device. But yeah, simple design. That's pretty much all I wanted for the garage anyway. And it's small, I can put it out of the way. It's got actually little spots on it where you can tack screws in it if you don't want it to move anywhere. It don't weigh anything. I mean, it's less than a pound. But there we go. Now I got a radio in the garage. Hooray!